क्वांटम नंबर्स। आर पॉसिबल, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सेट्स ऑफ क्वांटम नंबर्स आर पॉसिबल? ओके नाउ राइट द क्वेश्चंस। ए You have to send the answers in chat. Assalamu alaikum Abdul Wahid, how are you? Okay, he has not connected to the audio. Are you done, Shweb? Yes, Shweb, okay. Are you done? Okay. Let me know if you get stuck or something, okay? Evening, Abdul Wahid. How are you? Great. Please write this question, okay, Abdul Wahid? Please write this question. Yes, Shweb, are you done? Okay. Seen the screen. See at the screen. Let us first check the value of n and l. The conditions are how? The conditions are like this. N should be greater than l. L should be either greater than or equal to m, right? And s should be either plus half or minus half. These are the two. These are the conditions for n and l. Yeah, this is fine. This is okay. No, I mean the n and l values are fine. But when we look at L and M, azimuthal quantum number and principal quantum and magnetic quantum number, we see that magnetic quantum number is plus 2 and L is 1 only. So for this, the magnetic quantum numbers can also be minus 1, 0, plus 1. So this is not possible. And L is equal to 1, L is equal to 0, M is equal to 0, this is possible. N is greater than L, this is equal to, this is okay. And here this is 2 and it is minus 1. So obviously, yeah, L is greater than M. So this is also fine. N is equal to 2, this is okay. And M and L, see, L is equal to minus 1. There is no L for whom we have minus 1 as a number, right? We don't have, we all have S is 0, P is 1, B is 2, F is 3, G is 4, and so on. But L is never minus 1. So that is why D is also not possible. Please copy this. Copy this and let me know if you're done. Tape is done. I'm waiting for Abdul Wahid now. Shreve, what happened? Why you didn't answer?
Sir, I was solving all of them.
So you got the right answers?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Abdul Wahid, please copy this. Raise your hand when you are done. Another question. Now, please look at this question and how you will do this questions. Calculate B. Number of electrons in the following. Number of electrons in the following. Here we have been given A, n is equal to 3, l is equal to 0. Okay, n is equal to 3 and l is equal to 0. Question number B, here you have n is equal to 4, l is equal to 1. C, n is equal to, let us say again, 4, l is equal to 1, m is equal to minus 1. D, n is equal to 3. L is equal to 1, M is equal to 0, S is equal to plus half. Okay. So if you are asked to calculate the number of electrons, there can be also one more type of questions. Let us say like this, N is equal to 2. Okay. N is equal to 2. Now, how will we solve these type of questions? How will we solve these type of questions? So what you have to do here is, whenever you have been asked to calculate the number of electrons in the following, so they have been given, you have been given set of quantum numbers, 1 quantum number, 2 quantum number, 3 quantum number, up till 4 quantum numbers. Now, how to calculate the number of electrons that can satisfy these quantum numbers? So what you will do here, you will always check the last thing that is given. See, L is equal to how much? 0, right? So L is equal to 0, then you will just tell me the number of electrons. 0 means which subshell, Shreve? 0 means which subshell? Whose value is 0? Which subshell's value is 0?
S, sir, S.
S, yeah. Now, how many electrons can S hold? Maximum number of electrons that S can hold?
1.
1. So, the number of electrons for these quantum numbers? 1. 2 electrons, no? S can hold 2 electrons?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Now, what about L? Now tell me for this question, L is equal to 1. Now how did we compare this? We saw that, we see, if we write this whole thing, this is 3s. Now even if this is 3s, still it will be holding how many electrons only? 2 electrons. If you could see this complete thing, it is how much? It is 4p, because L is equal to 1 for p. And this will be holding how many electrons? P subshell is holds 6 electrons. Now this number that n is given here, it is not very much useful for us. Okay, so whenever you are asked to calculate the number of electrons, and you have been given the quantum numbers, then what you will look, you will look at the last quantum number that is given. Here it is L given, here is also L. Here we have been given M. Now M means the number of orbitals. So they have been given only minus one, that is one orbital, right? So in one orbital, how many? One orbital. It means it will have how many electrons? Only two electrons. Whatever the orbital is, you will have only two electrons, okay? Now, coming to the D question, they have given everything about the electron, everything about the electron. Now in the third shell, in the third shell, in the P sub shell and the magnetic quantum number zero, that is orbital number zero, you have one electron whose spin is plus half, whose spin is plus half. So this plus half can be only of one electron, right? Plus half can be of only one electron. Now here you have been given N is equal to two. So how many electrons can be there in N is equal to two? What is the formula? I guess we did this in the last class, na? Let me see. Yeah, we have done this. Tell me, N is equal to two. What is the maximum number of electrons that this shell can hold? What is the formula? So if look at your notes and tell me, Abdul Wahid, you also tell me in the chat, if N is equal to two, what is the maximum number of electrons that this shell can hold? Yes, Shweb, you can't find that? At the end of last class, we did this.
Sir, I think three.
I think I'm seeing that look in your notes. There is a formula that I am saying. Please look into your notes. Are you looking, Shweb?
Yes, sir, yes.
The number of electrons that a shell can hold, the maximum number of electrons a shell can hold is equal to, there is a formula which includes N. You could not find that? Shreya, please look at the remarks. In the last class, we did some remarks. Yes, Shreya, tell me.
So there's a the first formula, number of subshell in a given shell.
Then?
Well, equal to value of PQN.
I'm not asking that. What is this? Is this shell or subshell?
Subshell.
Subshell. Very good. Please revise this. Write the next topics, electronic configuration. Please study. Okay. Please study.
Okay, sir. I will. Ready? Sir, now because this Thursday we have exam in school.
I have told you many times, you need 15 minutes. You have to give your 15, complete 15 minutes before the class. Okay. Now, no matter what is going on, except if it is some very unfortunate event, then only you can't give 15 minutes to my subject, right? Before the class. Now in 15 minutes, you can go through everything what has been done in the last class if you just want to read it, okay? And most of the times I said that you have to, now if you can't do that, that you cannot give any excuse, right? For 15 minutes, can you give any excuse that there was exam? Tell me.
No, sir, no.
Yeah, exactly. So please, Hannah. Start learning. If you tell me sorry, if you give me excuse, that will not going. That is not going to help you. I understand that there must be something. That is why you didn't study. But what you have to keep in mind is that that's not an excuse. Okay. What you have to keep in mind that not. I understand that there must be something. That is why only you didn't study, because if you are coming here, attending the classes, and you are attending other classes also, you are in class 11, then I understand that you have some seriousness. That's why you have taken science and you want to do something, right? So, but please keep in one thing in mind, that there is no excuse for 15 minutes. So later at some point of time, you see that the exam is coming, then your brain is saying, yeah, your brain will say, let's leave chemistry today. Then you will say to your brain, no, I can study 15 minutes. That much amount of time I do have, I can study for 15 minutes. Okay. So this is for the later parts when your brain is trying to divert. Okay. Now let us write electronic configuration. Electronic configuration. Now, electronic configuration, this configuration is SPDF configuration. Okay, SPDF configuration. There is an off-power principle which directs how should we fill the electrons in different structure. Electrons in different structure. For example, in the lower standards, you must have heard that there is 2, 8, 8 like this. We keep on filling the electrons, right? But that is not the case now. We will be filling electrons in the smaller regions, that is in the subshells, okay? SPDF subshells. Now, that principle is known as off-bow principle. So this topic deals with the filling of electron. In various subshells. Okay. It is directed by off-bow principle. Okay. So what is the off-bow principle? What is the off-bow principle? Please write this. So it states a very obvious thing regarding the electrons. It states a very obvious thing. Why it is very obvious. We will study that also. It says that the distribution of electron takes place in different subshell or orbital in increasing order of their energy. Okay. Why this principle is very obvious? It is obvious because if we take any object, anything in this complete universe, all of them, they want to achieve the lowest possible energy state, their lowest possible energy state. A very good example for that is, a very good small experiment for that is, if you have a pen here that is above the table and then you drop it, then it comes down falling. Now this is happening automatically. You are not doing anything. Okay. You are not doing anything. Now why this is falling down? Why any change is happening? So we are interested in the change, right? So what change is happening? You held it in the top of the table. You dropped it. It is going down. Okay. I mean, you didn't apply any force also, but still it is going down. Why? Because let us say this is the ground state. And the top, the pen has some potential energy, right? The potential energy is greater than zero. There is some potential energy. But as we go down, the potential energy, it becomes zero. Now that is why from this experiment, small thought experiment, we can say that each and everybody in this universe, it wants to achieve the lowest possible energy state. Now for this particular pen, the lowest possible energy state at this point of time was the table. Now, if I also drop it down from the table, it will again go down to the ground, right? So everything, it wants to achieve the lowest possible energy state. So please write this Aufbau principle. Are you done, guys? Please raise your hand if you're done writing. Shoaib is done. Abdul Wahid, please write fast. Yes. Are you done? That right. Of what principle is composed of? Please write this with me. Of what principle? It's composed of three rules. Number one is N plus L rule. Number two, Hund's rule. Number three, Pauli's. Exclusion principle. Please write this also now. These 3 points, then we will start N plus L rule. Okay. Please write this fast, Abdul Wahid. And please start listening to me and keep writing, okay? You don't have to look at the board while you write, okay? Because also say the words, right? You don't have to look at the screen while you are writing. N plus L rule, Hund's rule, Pauli's exclusion principle. Just 3 points done. Abdul Wahid, are you done? Okay. Now please write the topic. N plus L rule. What does it give? It gives the relative energies of various subshells. So how can we find the relative energy of various subshells? A subshell having higher value of N plus L, higher value of N plus L has higher energy. Vivek, can you please unmute yourself? Can you turn the mic on? Yes. Can you speak? Can you tell me what is the value of N here? What is the value of L here? Yes, Abdul Wahid. You're not audible. Okay, Shoaib.
Yes, sir.
Abdul Wahid, no, I cannot hear you. What is the value of n in 4s?
4.
What is the value of l?
4.
What is l?
No,
which quantum 4, number? L is which quantum number?
Wait.
Abdul Wahid, can you answer? You can answer in the chat.
Zero. Sir, zero.
Okay. Abdul Wahid, can you answer in the chat? Yeah. So answer, tell me, Abdul Wahid, for this one. What is the value of n? N is equal to how much for this one? What is the value of L? Okay, for this one, what will be N plus L? For this, what will be N plus L? Now, please listen very carefully. Which has lower energy? Four s or two s? Please write in the chat, both of you. Which has lower energy? 4s or 2s? Yes, Abdul Wahid, correct. Shoaib, what do you think? Which has lower energy? 4s or 2s? Yes, Shoaib.
Do a circle.
Also compare for this one. For example, if I have something like this, example two, okay? So the example B. For example, you have something like 2P versus 3P. What is the value of N here, Shoaib, in 2P? What is the value of N?
2, sir.
What is the value of L?
1.
Okay, let us take this as 3S. What is the value of N here?
3.
What is the value of L?
0.
Now here also N plus L is equal to 3. Here also N plus L is equal to 3. Now, what to do in these type of cases? So please write the next thing. If you get the N plus L value, see. Okay. So write the next point. For two subshells, having same value of N plus L, the subshell having greater value of the subshell having greater value of what? The PQN. Okay. Having greater value of N has higher energy. Has higher energy. Okay. So what we will see, the first step is energy of subshell. How we will see energy of subshell? Okay. Energy of subshell. The first step is you see the value of n plus l. Okay, you see the value of n plus l. Now, whatever the n plus l value is, it is directly proportional to the energy. Because n plus l is higher, so step one. Then it will be higher energy. Now, if n plus l value come to be equal for two cases, then you will look at the value of n. This is also directly proportional to energy. Now, in those two values, whose n will be higher, that will have higher energy. So step two. So in this case, which has higher value? Here n is equal to 2, here n is equal to 3. Okay. So obviously this will have higher value because the n plus l is same. Now when n plus l is same, what we will look at? We will look at the value of n. So obviously 3 is greater than 2. That is why 3s will have higher energy than 2p. Did you get it? Abdul Wahid and Shoaib? What you have to do, can you get the values of n plus l same? Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Let me know if I can scroll down. Abdul Wahid, you see here and answer me. You have two subshells, 2p versus 3s. What is the value of n here in 2p? What is the value of L here in 2P? What is the value of N plus L? Now, one thing. Are you confirmed regarding the value of L? Please study. Abdul Wahid, please study. Please look in your notes. Start studying, guys. Start studying. Till quantum numbers, if you are not studying, that means that's a very bad sign. Okay. If you are weak in quantum numbers, that will haunt you till periodic tables and the p-block elements of 12th standard. Okay. So please flip some pages in your notes, Abdul Wahid, and tell me what is the value of L for 2p. Yes, please, Abdul Wahid. Okay. Now, if you're asking me a question two, that means you're not confirmed. Okay. And that is also not a right, that is also not the right answer. Yes. What is L? Can you tell me what is L? Which quantum number is that? L? What is the name of that quantum number? Okay, you don't know. If you don't know, sir, please say that you don't know. L denotes which quantum number, Abdul Wahid? Shoaib, can you answer in chat? Okay, now if you don't know, then please flip some pages in your notes. Start looking at quantum numbers. Start looking at quantum numbers. What are those quantum numbers? What is it in? It was, what is it denoted by? Okay. Please start studying. Please start studying. After quantum numbers, you will not get any time. Okay. These are the basics. No one is going to, even you will not be studying the basics once again. Even if I take any class, now you will not be studying. Why? because you will be feeling bored, because the tendency of a person is that he don't want to learn the same thing twice. Okay. Please look, Abdul Wahid, and tell me what is L, which quantum number. There are four quantum numbers. Out of those four quantum numbers, what is L? I hope you write notes. Do you write notes, Abdul Wahid? So please look now, quantum numbers. Start with quantum numbers where you have started quantum numbers. You could not find L anywhere. Angular quantum number, very good. You found that in the book, in your notebook. Okay, in my notebook. Exactly. So you don't write my notes? Angular momentum. So what I am saying is it very tough, Abdul Wahid. Have you not written for quantum numbers? The first topic, quantum numbers, there I have defined quantum numbers, and after that I have told you that there are four types of quantum numbers. God. Why can't you find? Shreve, I'm asking you also, please send in chat. What is L? Which quantum number is that? Yes, Shreve, am I audible? I'm not asking what is the value of L. I'm asking which quantum number is that? There are four quantum numbers, right? Out of those four, which quantum number is denoted by L? And Abdul Wahid, you could not find L anywhere in your notebook, in my notes. No. Okay. Can you get to the page quantum number? The first heading of this chapter, quantum number. If you get to that page, please say yes, sir. Now, you must be seeing the definition of quantum numbers, a set of four numbers, which tells you about the location of electron, right? And after that, I have told that there are four quantum numbers. Yes or no? There are four quantum numbers. Yes or no? Yeah. What is the first quantum number that I have written? What is the first quantum number? What is the second quantum number? See, I have written everything. Okay. Now, please look at your notes, read your notes. At least you should be knowing where these things are present. Can you see this? Can you see the symbol now? Abdul Wahid, can you see the symbol now? But please start studying, Abdul Wahid. This should not be happening again. Okay. This should not be happening again. If you have the notes, you should be at least able to tell the answer from the notes by looking at it. Now listen here. And Abdul Wahid, get your mic fixed. Can you please turn the mic on? Yeah, please turn the mic on. You are not able to turn the mic on. What is happening? Okay. That's okay. I am not worried about that. Please turn the mic on. Please turn the mic on. Please don't wait for the disturbance to stop. Please turn the mic on. Now speak something. Yeah, you're audible now. Okay. You're audible now. Please, if you have the mic, please keep that mic near your mouth. I think it is a bit faint that because your mic is away. Can you speak once again? Read this part. Read this.
Energy of
sessions. Yeah, you're audible. Okay. Now, please listen. If you will look at the azimuthal quantum number now, we have taught there that the value, the S, P, D, F, these are the subshells. They have the value 0, 1, 2, and 3. These are the value of azimuthal quantum number for the following subshells. Okay. Now, tell me. What will be the value here for 2p? Yes, tell me what will be the value for 2p? Can you say that once more?
It will be 2 into 1, right?
2 into 1, no. You just have to tell me what subshell is there. Tell me which subshell is present. S, P, D or F? Can you please say that once more? You don't know which subshell is there? My voice is lagging. My voice is lagging, Shoaib. Or is it only for
sir, his voice is yes, low, sir. Very...
No. Is my voice lagging?
No, sir.
No. Okay. Thank you. There must be some problem at your end. Okay. See, Abdul Wahid, if you're not able to interact, that means I will have to go like this, and you will ask me wherever you find it difficult. Okay. Now it's very tough for me to ask everything and read everything from the chat. Now L will be equal to 1 because as we have said that S is 0 and for P it is 1, for D it is 2 and for F it is 3. Now N plus L will be equal to here. 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. But here N is equal to 3 because it is in third shell. L will be equal to 0 because it is S and the value of S for azimuthal quantum number is equal to 0. Now N plus L here also. It is equal to 3. Now, we are in a situation of a tie in the first step, right? We have seen the N plus L and the N plus L for both of these subshells. Now, the step 2 says that you have to look at the N. So, we'll write the N here. N is equal to 2 here. And we will write the N here. N is equal to 3 here. Now, from this comparison of N, principal quantum number, we can say that N of 3 is greater than N of 2, right? So, we can obviously say that this is greater. That is why this will have greater energy. Will have greater energy. 3s will have greater energy. That is why 3s will have greater energy than 2p. Okay. Now please write this. Raise your hand if you are done. I hope you must be done by now. Please raise your hand if you are done. Okay, Abdul Wahid is also done. Now I'm giving you a very simple question, okay, to start. Write the name of subshells for following. Please write this question with me. So here you have the, wait a second, let me write it like this. Here we will have the values of n. Here we will have the values of l. And here you will have the subshells. Okay. Here we will have the subshell. Now I'm doing a few for you. Let me write. N is equal to 1, L is equal to 0. Okay. So for 1, you will write what is the shell? Shell is 1. What is the value of, what is the subshell for 0? It is 1s. Then, for example, if you have 2, 0, then it will be 2. For L, it will be s. Then again, 2, 1. This will be what? Then again, you will write 2 here. And for 1, it is p. Please tell me now, Shoaib and Abdul Wahid. Did you understand this? How will you write this subshell? I will be giving you N and L. Yes or no? Did you understand it or should I do it once more? Got it. Okay. I'm just writing the values of L. For example, S means the values of L should be 0. P means it should be 1. B means it should be 2. F means it should be 3. So please write this. This is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, and K. You'll start from B, okay? You will start answer from B. Please let me know if you are done. Okay. Abdul Wahid, are you done? Okay, Abdul Wahid is done. What about Shoaib? PS, 3P, 3D, 4S, 4P, 4D, 4F, 5S. Okay. So now the opposite also can be done, right? From here, you calculated the subshell name from the values of N and L. The opposite can also be done. So please write a question for that. Determine the values of N and L for following, and also comment if the subshell is valid. Okay, so let me first copy this. So here we will write the subshell. Here we will write the values of N, the value of L, and the validity. Okay, and the validity. So please see, you have only N and L. The only criteria is that for a subshell to be valid, that N should be greater than L, right? This is the only criteria. N should be greater than L. And also that N should be positive, and L should also be positive, okay? N should be not positive, rather it should be positive. Let me write the criteria for everything that you should have in this particular question. N should be 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. L should be equal to 0 to N minus 1. That is equal to how much? Means L should be always, less than N, okay? L should be always less than N. But all these, this also should be positive, and this can be whole number. That means 0, 1, 2, these things, okay? But it should be always less than N. It should be always less than N. So you'll keep these things in mind. This is the subshell number. I will do a few for you, okay? For example, if you, I write, let us say 1P. If I write 1P, the value of N is equal to how much? 1. The value of L is equal to also how much? 1. If this N and L are equal, so please, Shoaib, tell me, will this subshell be valid or not? And Abdul Wahid, please tell me in the chat. the N and L are equal, right? So will it be valid or not valid? Abdul Wahid, can you please tell me in chat if it will be valid or not? What is the condition? N should be greater than N, la. Yes, Abdul Wahid. So please listen carefully at least. I'm writing everything. Okay. I hope you guys write this also while you are doing this. Okay. So this will be not valid, right? Forgot. I have written this. How can you say forgot? Please listen carefully. N and L. Validity will be, it's not valid. So you'll make a cross here. Okay, it is not valid. So 1P, you will never see a subshell which is called 1P. Now you will do the similar kind of thing with all of the following subshells. So please write 2S, 3D, 2D, 1F, 3S, 2F, 4S, 3P, 4D, 4F. You will tell me the values of N, L, and whether it is right or wrong. Okay. So you can send the answers like this. This is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, and K. So you will send me answers from B. Okay. If you are done with B, send me the answer. You will send it like this. For example, I am writing for the A1. Okay. I'm writing for the A1. For A, you will send the answer as 1, 1, W. W means wrong, and you will say right if it is right, okay? If it is cross, you will say wrong by W, and then you will separate these things N and L by a comma, and after that you will write a W. For B also, you will give the answer in the same way. So as soon as you are done with B, send me the answer. As soon as you are done with C, send me the answer, okay? Please don't wait. You don't have to do all and send me the answer. Send the initial one first and after that the later ones. Okay, I have got one. Yes, Shoaib, that is correct. You can look at your notes azimuthal quantum number if you will see. Okay, I think I need to give everything for you guys. You guys don't study anything. You're not able to do? Abdul Wahid? Abdul Wahid, I said A is, this is B, Abdul Wahid. Okay, you can't see something. This is B. So you are saying this is valid. A is valid, you are saying, Abdul Wahid. God. Yes, Abdul Wahid, are you saying that A is valid? Yes or no? Huh. Correct your mistake, Nadal. Correct your mistake. Now, how you have to write? You have to write it like this. B, please, Abdul Wahid, A, I will not comment on your answer whether it is right or not if you don't send me in this fashion. A, 1, 1, then you will say it is valid or not valid, whatever you want, but you will write W. Simple thing I'm saying. Please follow this. Otherwise, I will not comment on your answers. You have been given simple instruction. Please follow it. Thank you. Hmm. Yes, very good, Abdul Wahid. Thank you. So this is 2. This is 0. This is valid. Abdul Wahid, please write the points here, okay? Please write the points. Don't make mistakes like this. N should be greater than L. For S, what is the value of S, Abdul Wahid? What is the value of S? For P? For D? Now C or C answer. Now see the answer that you have given for C, this question. Did you get the mistake? Yeah, very good. Okay, Shayab. G, again, Shayab, please look at the value of L for G. Please look at the value of L for G. Please don't be in a hurry. Yes, D is correct, Abdul Wahid. So A looks at the value of azimuthal quantum number for the G question. Yes, very good, Abdul Wahid. Correct, E. Yes, now it is correct. Okay, for F, yeah, it is correct, Abdul Wahid. For G, Abdul Wahid, yeah, it is correct. Shreve, for G, it is now correct. For H, correct, Shreve. Yes, Abdul Wahid, correct. Yeah, Abdul Wahid, correct. Yes, correct. Shayab also. Okay, let me just start this now. So for this, it will be 3 and for D, it will be 2. So yeah, it is correct. This will be 2 and 2. It is not valid. This will be 1 and 3. This will be not valid. This will be 3 and 0. This will be valid. This will be 2 and 3. This will be not valid. This will be 4 and 0, this will be valid. This will be 3 and 1, it will be valid. This will be 4 and 2, it will be valid. This will be 4 and 3, this will be valid. Okay, thank you. So I hope that you are now very much comfortable with the, if I give you any subshell, you can find the N and L, and also you can comment on the validity. Yes, Abdul Wahid and Shoaib, yes or no? Yes, okay. After this, now this all thing we have done because we need to calculate the order of energy, okay? Order of energy. Now, the question is, compare the energy of compare the energy of following. Okay, compare the energy of following. So let's start with A. Please write 1s versus 2s. B, please write 2s versus 2p. For C, please write 2p versus 3s. What you have to do, n plus l, right? You have to do n plus l. So you will write it like this. For this, n is equal to 1, l is equal to 0. This will be equal to 1. For this guy, we have n is equal to 2, l is equal to 0. So the n plus l for this one is, will be equal to 2, right? So this has more energy, right? This has more energy, like this. This has more energy. And I'm following. And which of the two is less? So obviously we can say that 1s is lesser here. Okay, 1s is lesser here. Then you have 2p versus 3s. After that we will write CB. 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s. 3s versus PP. 3p versus 4s. 4s versus 4p. 4s versus 3, we'll decide first. So, Abe and Abdul Wahid, please write in the chat if you understood what you have to do. I hope you guys have understood what you have to do. Please write yes or no in the chat. I can explain once more. Should I explain once more? No, okay. For G, you write 3D. Okay, Abdul Wahid. For H, you write, very good. For P versus 5S, okay. So how you are going to do, you will write the n plus l. So n plus l for here, it will be equal to 1 plus 0. This will be 2 plus 0. So this will be equal to 1. This will be equal to 2. Now from these two, we can say that 1s is the lowest, okay? So you will answer me like this. You'll write A, 1s. And you will see, look at B. For B here, it is 2 plus 0. This is 2 plus 1. So this is equal to 2. This is equal to 3. So obviously, which is lower, okay? Whatever is lower, you will write that, okay? Whatever is lower. So in these two, which is lower? 2s is lower. So you will write 2s. So in the answer, you will tell me for B, it is 2s. Now, as soon as you have done for A, B, and C, just keep sending me, okay? You keep sending me. Yes, Abdul Wahid, correct. This is 2p. Yes, Shoaib, correct. Abdul Wahid, please look at the C. Abdul Wahid, please look at the C. How? Can you explain it? Why it is 2P, Abdul Wahid? Now here, 2 plus 1 plus 3, 2 plus 1 equals to 2. Yeah, this is 2 plus 1 equals to 3. And for this also, it is equal to 3 plus 0, which is equal to 3. Now, this became equal. So what did you check next? It is equal, so we can't see now. So now what do we have to do? Abdul Wahid, what should we do now? If it is equal, what should we check? What is the step two? What should we check? Step two. Yes, very good. So whose n is higher? 2p or 3s? Whose n is higher? 3 is higher, right? So which will win here? Whose is lower? 2p is lower. Very good. Please go on. Wait a second, let me check this. Okay. So I'm writing the answers here. Okay. So between 3s and 3b, you will have 3 here and there will be 4 here. So obviously 3s will be winning here. Between 3p and 4s, this will be 4 and this will also be 4. But we will look at the n. So n is small for 3p, then 3p will win here. This will be 4 and this will be 3 plus 2, 5. So obviously 4s will be winning here. 3d is 5. 4p is again 5. Now we will look at the principal quantum number. So 4 is higher here. That is why 3d will win here. Now between 4p, this is 5 and this is also 5. Now between these two, the principal quantum number is greater for 5s. That is why 4p will win here. For 5s and 4d, we have 5 here and we have 6 here. So we can say that 5s will be winning between 5s and 4d. Between 4D and 5P, we have 4 plus 2, which is equal to 6, and 5 plus 1, which is also equal to 6. And in these two cases, 5P has greater value of N. That is why 4D will be winning. And after that, 5P and 6S, we have this is 6, and this is also 6. But here, the principal quantum number of 6S is higher. That is why 5P will be winning. After that, we have 6S versus 4F. Here, what we have is 6, and 4F is 7, because 4 plus 3. The value of L for F is equal to 3. Here, obviously, 6S will be winning because the N plus L is lower. Now, here, what will be winning is 4 plus 3, which is 7, and this 5 plus 2, which is also be 7. This in this case, this principal quantum number is higher here. That is why 4F will be winning. That is, it has lesser energy. Between 5D and 6P, this is 7, and this is also 7. But in this case, 6P has the greater principal quantum number, that is why 6P will be winning. Abdul Wahid, you have missed the last one. 5 plus 2, 6 plus 1, both are 7. But in this case, principal quantum number is higher for 6P, that is, okay, sorry. Sorry, I have messed up. Did I miss anywhere else? Everything else is 5, no? 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, 4p, 5s, 4d, 5p, 6s, 4f, 5d. Yeah, it's fine. Everything's fine. Okay. Now, what you have here is this is a very great thing. Now, of the all of the orbitals, now, Shreve, you will tell me if you can speak. Can you speak, Shreve? Yes, Shreve, can you speak? Energy order of subshell. Shreve, please tell me which of those subshells that we have written in the above examples, which has the lowest energy? Which has the lowest energy, Shreve? Abdul Wahid, can you send in chat? Shreve, you are not audible. Abdul Wahid, please tell me which has the lowest energy. 1s, no? 1s. 1s has the lowest energy, right? Now, after 1s? Yes. Shreve, what is happening? Why you are not audible? Note 1p, see? 1p not ex- does not exist, guy.
Yes, sir. Yes, yes.
Abdul Wahid, please don't get hurry up. Please don't hurry. Tell me, will 1p exist? Calculate the value. No, exactly. So please don't hurry. You have the answers, okay? You have the energy of order like this. See? You have 1s, after that there is 2s, after that there is 2p, then 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, 4p, 5s, 4d, 5p, 6s. And after that you have 4f and 5d. So please listen and write carefully the energy order of subshell. So write the order. 1s has lowest energy, after that there is 2s, after that there is 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, 4p. After that you have 5s, 4d, 5p. After that you have 6s, 4f. After 4f we have 5d. After 5d we will have 6p. After 6p we will have 7s. After 7s we will have, after 7s it is fine, but you can have others also. 7 minus 2 is equal to 5, and 5 can have 4. Okay. Till 7s you can write till 7s, okay? That means you can write it here only. Now, 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, 4p, 5s, 5d, 5p, 6s, 4f, 5d, 6p. Please mark this like this. Please mark it like this. Let me know if you're done. Please mark it like this and tell me if you're done. Yes, Shreve, are you done? What about Muhammad Abdul Wahid? Please raise your hand if you're done. Okay, now please listen very carefully. You don't have to remember this, okay? You don't have to remember this. I will give you a formula. You will apply that formula. I mean, there is one way, if you can memorize this, it's all well and good. You can memorize it. But what I would suggest is don't memorize this. Rather, just memorize this particular formula. Ns, n minus 2f, n minus 1d, and NP. Okay. NS, N-2F, N-1D, NP, okay? Now, what are we going to do with this formula here? We will start with N is equal to 1. Shiv, can you turn your mic off? Check validity for each term. What is the term? Term is something that has this type of bracket underneath it or above it. Check validity for each term. Then move on. Okay, then move on. So it may seem a bit complex, but once we will complete this, you will find it very easy. Okay, you will find it very easy. The only thing that I am asking right now is please pay attention. I will be asking very few simple questions that you have already done. And then what we will do from this formula, this small formula here, we can recreate this particular long form of the order of energy of subshells. Okay. So Shoaib, can you please speak? You were not audible the last time because I need someone to answer me a few things. Yes, Shoaib, can you please unmute?
Sir.
Yes. Can you please read the first line? Can you please read the first
one?
N is equal to 1. So we will put N is equal to 1. Yeah. Now, the next thing is they are saying check the validity for each term, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, check the validity for each term. Now, we will put this 1 on this term, that is 1s, ns. Okay. This is ns, right? So if I put N is equal to 1 in this term, this term will become what? 1s. Yes or no? Okay, very good. Now tell me, yes. Is 1s possible? Please think and tell. Is 1s possible? If you want some time, please take a notebook, write with your pen the values of N and the values of L. And I want the answer from Abdul Wahid also. Does 1s exist? Yes or no? In the chat. Does 1s exist? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. What about Abdul Wahid? Okay. Abdul Wahid has also answered. Yes, 1s exists. Very good. Now, after that, you will move on, right? You have checked the validity for the first term. Then you will move on to the next term. What is this? N is equal to 2, right, Shreya? The next term is N minus 2F. The next term is N minus 2F, right? Now, if what will happen if I insert N is equal to 1 in this term? What will happen if I insert N is equal to 1 in this term?
What will happen? 1 minus 2 into F.
So 1 minus 2 will be equal to how much? Minus 1, right?
Minus 1.
Minus 1F. So tell me, does minus 1F exist? Yes or no?
No, sir.
No, it does not exist, right? N cannot be minus. So you will cross this. Now tell me for N minus 1D, what will be the value for this term?
0.
0D. Will 0D exist?
No, sir.
No. Abdul Wahid, are you getting it? Abdul Wahid will now answer. What will be this term? NP. What will be this term? If I put N is equal to 1, then this term will become? You just have to put N is equal to 1 and write as it is. Yes, Abdul Wahid. Please try Abdul Wahid, okay? This is a very simple thing that I am saying. You have NP, and I am saying N is equal to 1. Then what will be this term? If N is equal to 1, then how can I write this term? Yeah, it's NP. It's small, okay? It is small case, not uppercase, okay? It is lowercase. This will be, it's NP, right? It's NP. And I'm saying N is equal to 1. So what will this become? Substitute the value, no? You have N, N is equal to 1. Substitute the value. See here how I have written 1s. Similarly, this will be 1p, no? I don't know why you are not getting this. Got it now? Now, Abdul Wahid, do you understand? It is very difficult if you don't have the mic, if you don't have a proper mic, or if your voice is not audible to me. Yes or no? So please get it fixed. Do whatever you can. Okay. Now, if it is working in some other class, then I don't know. But there is no problem in my end, because even Shoaib cannot listen to you. If there was some problem at my end, then obviously Shoaib would have been able to hear you, but he's not. So please get it fixed. Okay. Please get it fixed. This will be 1P. Now you will tell me, Abdul Wahid, does 1P exist? Yes or no? Please calculate and tell. Please don't tell like this. Use your pen and paper. Write the values of N. Write the values of L for 1P. Compare it with the criteria and tell me if it will exist or not. And tell me if it will exist or not. Babe, you also sent the answer in chat. Will 1P exist? Yes or no? What is the value of N here, Shoaib, in 1P? What is the value of N? Shoaib, what is the value of N?
1.
What is the value of L?
L?
Yeah, L. You know.
1.
So, will it exist?
Yes, sir. No.
You mean no. You are saying yes and you mean no. You will be having a great problem if you face something in court.
Yes, you are saying yes, yes.
Okay. So, when I put N is equal to 1, yes, Abdul Wahid, you are right. Abdul Wahid, you are right. Okay. If we put N is equal to 1 from this particular whole formula, I got only 1s, right? Now, what it is saying, move on. So we will move on. We will erase all these things. Now, Abdul Wahid, you will help me. Okay. Please be active in the chat. Please be active in the chat. You have to answer very simultaneously. N is equal to 2. What will be the value of ns if N is equal to 2? Very good. Now tell me, does 2s exist? Yes or no, Abdul Wahid? Yes, very good. What will be the value for n minus 2f if I put n is equal to 2 in this term? N minus 2f. I have to put n is equal to 2. Yeah, so what will be the value for this term? Now tell me, Will 0f exist? Yes or no? Will 0f exist? Yes or no? Very good. What will be the value for n minus 1d if n is equal to 2? What is the value of n minus 1d if n is equal to 2? Very good. Will 1d exist? Yes or no? Will 1d exist? Yes or no? Did you do it in with pen and paper, or you are seeing just by looking at it? Seems like you didn't do. Yeah, do it. Oh, please do it. Yes, very good. 1D will not exist. What about here? What will be the value of this term NP if n is equal to 2? If n is equal to 2, Abdul Wahid, please don't make me angry. Yeah, thank you. 2P. So if I put n is equal to 2 in this formula, what are the subshells that I am getting? The correct subshells are 2p will exist, yes or no? First tell me that 2p will exist, yes or no? Yes. So the subshell that I'm getting is only 2s and 2p. So then you will write 2s, 2p. So can you see that you are getting the order? Can you see that you are getting the order now? Yes. Now we will again do for 3. Shoaib, are you ready for 3? Yes, Shoaib. Okay. Seems Shoaib is not here. Abdul Wahid, you answer me. If n is equal to 3, where were you?
No,
why
sir,
you take... Sorry?
I was just messaging someone. Sorry for that.
Okay, now whatever you do now, that is very much visible in the performance. Okay, so please try to pay attention at one thing at a time. If you are,
yes, sir.
Thank you. No. So if there is time for something and you don't give it time, then obviously chemistry will also return the same things back to you. Okay. So, I mean, not only chemistry, whether I mean, if it is physics also, it will return the same things back to you, whatever input you are giving. So please tell me for NS, Abdul Wahid, you can also answer in the chat. If you can work it fast, then you can answer the whole thing in the chat for NS and minus 2F if N is equal to 3. Okay. Please try it, Abdul Wahid. And Shreya, you will tell me now, what will be the value of NS if N is equal to 3?
Yes.
3s. So will 3s exist? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What will be the value of n minus 2f if n is equal to 3?
1f.
Will 1f exist? Abdul Wahid, please don't say anything, Shoaib. Abdul Wahid, will 1f exist? No. Very good. Shoaib, what will be the value for n minus 1d?
2D.
Abdul Wahid will tell me whether this will exist or not. Will 2D exist? Yes or no? For NP, it will be how much? 3P, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so 3P will exist. Now, as you can see, if I put 3 here, I will get PS, 3P. As you can see that it is still following the energy of those subshells. Okay, now let me also try for 4. Nobody has to answer for 4. If I put in ns, this will be equal to 4s. If I put this in n minus 2f, this will be 4 minus 2f, and this will be equal to 2f. Now obviously 2f will not exist. And then we have n minus 1d, this will be 4 minus 1d, this will become 3d. So yes, 3d exists. For np, it will be 4p. Right, so the shells which we are getting is 4s, 3d, 4p. We can also do the same thing for 5. We can also do the same thing for 5. This will be 5s, 4 minus 2. Oh, sorry, 5 minus 2. This will be 3f. So obviously 3f will not exist. Then 4 minus 1, 5 minus 1, this is 4d. And we will have 5p. So the subshells that we are getting are 5s, 4d, 5p. Okay, the next we have 6. For 6, we can write 6s, 4f, this also exists, and 5b, and after that, 6p. So you will have 6s, 4f, 5b, 6p. Okay. So I hope now you can write this particular energy of subshells using this formula. Yes or no? Shoaib and Abdul Wahid? You don't have to remember everything, yes, okay? Sir. Now, even if you want to remember it, you should remember it like this, how I have marked all these things, okay? The way I have marked these things. So you will remember 1s, then you will remember 2s, 2p. Then you will remember 3s, 3p. 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p. 4s, 3d, 4p. 5s, 4d, 5p. 6s, 4f, 5d, 6p. Okay. So you will assume this to be one syllable, this to be one syllable, this to be one syllable. Similarly, this to be one syllable. Okay. This to be one syllable. So if you remember it like this, then it will be very easy for you in electronic configuration. And you will understand why it will be very easy in electronic configuration when we do electronic configuration. Okay. So now please write a note here. The energy of order is 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, and so on. The same energy of order that we have seen. But the order of energy of subshells for single electron system means hydrogen and hydrogen like, right? Because hydrogen has how many electrons? Hydrogen has only one electron. Now if I look at hydrogen, then we will look at helium positive. If we remove one electron from helium, that will also have only one electron. Similarly, helium, lithium 2 positive, this will also have only one electron. Okay, so hydrogen and hydrogen-like atoms. The energy of the subshells, which is equal to 1s. Now 1s is lower than 2s, but 2s and 2p are equal. The reason, I will tell you the reason. 2s and 2p are equal. Then we have 3s, which is equal to 3p, which is equal to 3d. Then we have 4s, which is equal to 4f, right? 4p, 4d. And it is also equal to 4f. Okay, is also equal to 4f. Now, what is the reason for this? The reason for this, please listen now. The reason for this is that For example, you have multi-electron system. Okay, this is one of the nucleus. You have one shell, second shell, third shell, fourth shell. There will be some electrons here. There will be some electrons in this orbital, in this shell. There will be some electrons in this shell. Right? There will be some electrons in this shell. Now, if there is multi-electron system, what is happening? There is the attraction force of nucleus, which is attracting these nucleus, these electrons towards the nucleus. But there is also one more thing, which is electronic repulsion. Due to electronic repulsion, it leads to the energy of order, which is, it also depends on, because of electron repulsion, it also depends on the subshell. In which the electron is present. But let us look at what will happen if we have just a single electron system. So this is the shells. Now, either you will have the electron in this shell, or you will have the electron in this shell, or you will have the electron in this shell, right? Or you have the electron in this shell. Now, whatever shell is present, now in single electron system, there is no electron repulsion. Now, the only force that is acting in this single electron system is the attractive force of the nucleus on the electron. The protons which are present, they are attracting the electrons. But here we have two things. Here we have the attraction of nucleus and also the electron repulsion. That is why it depends on two things, the subshell and also the shell, right? The energy will depend on two things, that is subshell because of electron repulsion, and from shell, why? Because of the attraction from the protons. Now, in this single electron system, there is no electronic repulsion. That is why it will only depend on only on shell. Why only on shell? Because the only force that is acting in this case is the attractive force of this nucleus, this protons which is present in the nucleus on this particular electron. That is why only shell matters. The subshell don't matter. That is why we have 1s, and after that we have the second shell, then the third shell, then the fourth shell. Okay. So please write these two points. Let me know if you're done. Then we will leave. Lab is done. Waiting for Abdul Wahid. Abdul Wahid, are you done? Write these two points, okay? The order of energy of subshells for multi-electron system and for single electron system. Yes, Abdul Wahid. You are still writing. Save if you are done, then you can leave. Thank you. Okay, we will meet on.